So Kevin, you're very welcome to Polymateria's laboratories at Imperial Innovations in London. Mm-hmm. Historically, you've been very sceptical around biodegradability as a credible solution for plastic pollution. Can you just share where that scepticism is coming from?
What we've seen with biodegradable materials, particularly plastics, is that the science doesn't underwrite the fact that they're actually doing what they're sent to do. They leave microplastics in the environment. The other part of it is that if they do get into the waste stream, they often contaminate more traditional waste recycling.
Okay.
So they're not helping us in each way.
Okay, and there's a confusion with the consumer as well, whether it's compostable, biodegradable, they don't know what's the right end of life action to take.
Yes, and if you're lucky enough to have a compost bin and you put it in there, fine. That's about 4% of the population. So what does the other 96% do with the biodegradable material? There is no facility, or there are very few facilities in the UK that this actually happens in. Do you put it in with the wet waste? Not a good thing to do, because that's not wanted either. So it sounds good on paper, but actually in reality the practical things mean that it doesn't do what we're all expecting it to do.
You've been following our business for quite a while. From a biotransformation perspective, what do you think our new technology is getting right, and where do you think we've got more work to do?
I think what's exciting about what you've been doing is you've been proving things by science.
Yeah.
You've been showing that actually this does not leave residual plastic in the environment. It is actually completely neutral. I think also that it actually allows us to continue to use conventional polymers, whether they're bio-sourced or whether they're actually from fossil fuels. It allows me still to recycle those plastics. But at the end of life, you've given me a safeguard that it won't hang around in the environment forever. So I think those are the really critical things that you've built into your system.
Now, there's a term that you've been very fond of since you and I first met, which is this, how you take all of that science, if you want, and technology, and simplify it down so that people can really understand it. And that concept is plastic that rusts. Is that still a concept that you're wedded to?
I think we've got to describe it to the customer really simply.
Yeah.
And I, as you know, I came up with that phrase because it was just one way of saying what this is actually doing. It's not maybe the absolute precise the right metaphor, but it kind of describes what we're doing with the polymer.
Now, you know, I'm not a fan.
No. So
I have been thinking about it in preparation for today. Given we've one whole laboratory here that's dedicated to getting the timing right,
yes,
to give recycling every chance to happen, fitting therefore the circular economy, what we could do is now associate a recycle by date with the packaging. Mm. So if consumers are used to the concept of a use by date or a sell by date, if we also now added into the packaging a stamp that would tell them what date they need to recycle it by, do you think that could be used in a way that could help enable the circular economy and encourage consumers to recycle more?
I think it's a very good idea. I think it helps the consumer. It works with the circular economy. It allows us to design things that are designed to have a circularity and a recycle point. It also then helps with some of the PRN issues and how we actually encourage the recyclers to collect and to recycle, because they've got a finite time on it as well. So I think all in all, that could be a very good way of approaching it.
Okay, fantastic. And then finally, the role of standards. So false claims have been a real issue in the past. One of the things Polymateria has done is to open source the standards that we're actually testing to, and to share that with BSI, ASTM, CEN, and so on. Do you think we need to have better goalposts around anybody who's making claims in this space? And how much do you think that can help with credibility?
I think it's long overdue. I think it's a universal standard, a global standard for biodegradability. What does it actually mean? And there are so many people who are entering the market with biodegradable claims that don't substantiate it. So I think it really needs to happen quite soon.
Right, and treat this like a global emergency. So do it with urgency, not taking 2-3 years.
And we have got the circular economy package to deal with as well, which says we have to design for circularity. You can't design a biodegradable material for circularity. So traditional biodegradable systems will not be covered by the circular economy package. So,
and this resolves that issue?
Yes.
Yes, okay.
Kevin, you've been instrumental in helping to shape not just this technology, but the business. We've listened very carefully to what you've advised us on along the way, so just to thank you for your time, and also wish you the best.
Thank you very much, Neil. Cheers.